Hey, there's two things you should know about me. One, I love the band Nirvana. And two, well, I guess there's not much else. Roll the title. To properly understand Nirvana, you must start off with the mastermind himself, Kurt Donald Cobain. Kurt was born in Aberdeen, Washington in 1967. If you are thinking to yourself, gee, I've never heard of that place before. Exactly. It was a small town where not much happened, and to cope with the boredom, Kurt turned to music, specifically the Beatles and punk rock, which both heavily influenced his music. He began playing the guitar and writing music, hoping one day to form a band. Eventually, Kurt met Chris Novoselic, who was a fellow fan of punk rock. Kurt had Chris listen to a demo of his, specifically this one, which I'll play right now.
There's a soft, pretentious mountains, glisten in the light of the trees, and all the flowers sing in D minor, and the birds fly happily.
Yeah, that's the demo that started it all. Only Chris would listen to that and say, sign me up. I guess he had good intuition, though. These two formed what we now know as Nirvana. They went through quite a few drummers for many years. One of the most notable drummers in the beginning days of the band was Chad Channing, who was the drummer for most of the songs recorded for the Bleach album in 1989.
Bleach was the first studio album of theirs, and it was released under the Sub Pop label. Sub Pop was best known for signing many Seattle-based grunge and punk bands in the early 90s. Eventually, Chad left the band and was replaced with Dave Grohl in 1990. Kurt, Chris, and Dave became what we now know as the faces of Nirvana. After some time, the band split from Sub Pop Records, with much scrutiny, and signed into a larger label, DGC Records. Under this label, they released what ended up becoming a genre-defining album, Nevermind. The most popular song to come out of this album was Smells Like Teen Spirit. Nevermind and Smells Like Teen Spirit have been credited as changing the entire rock genre for many years to come. The mainstream loved it, and Nirvana skyrocketed. Kurt has said that the hype around Nirvana was similar to Beatlemania in the 60s. It was inevitable for them to create another album. The third and final album of Nirvana was In Utero. Kurt wanted this album to go back to the band's roots, with a more raw and unpolished sound, similar to the Bleach era. The following tour to go along with this album was going to be big, with former member of the punk band The Germs, Pat Smear, playing rhythm guitar. Unfortunately, this tour was cut short due to the tragic death of Kurt. All in all, Nirvana was a groundbreaking band that continues to live on in the hearts of many fans, including myself. So yes, Nirvana is not a clothing brand, it is a band, and you should listen to their stuff because it's really good.